Now, what I'd like to do in this video is talk a little bit about this 95% confidence interval of the difference, which can be another way to assess the significance of the test. First of all, notice that there was a 6.33 point mean difference between the students who took the program and the untreated population. How is this obtained? Well, notice the mean is 86.33 for our sample. The untreated population mean is 80. So if I take 86.33 and subtract 80 from that, I will get, in fact, 6.33. So that's where this value comes from. Now what we can do is we can build a confidence interval, which is done for us automatically in SPSS, around this mean difference of 6.33. And this confidence interval ranges from 1.84 all the way up to 10.82. Okay, this is our 95% confidence interval of the difference. And the way you interpret this is, from a hypothesis testing perspective or through significance testing, is that if this range includes the value 0 anywhere in it, then the test is not significant. Okay, if 0 is in this range, then the p-value will be greater than 0.05. The test will not be significant. Notice here 0 is not in this range. The bottom of the interval is 1.84. So this does not include 0. If this was, say, negative 1.84, then 0 would be included in this range. And if this was negative 1.84, then this would be greater than 0.05, the p-value, by definition. Okay, so these will always agree in the sense that if this test is significant, then this will not include 0. If it's not significant, then 0 will be in this range. And what I'd like to do is to play with the data just for a minute to try and show you how this is the case. So let's go back to our data editor window here. And recall that the untreated population mean is 80. So I'm going to go ahead and make some of these values much closer to 80. And of course, I'm doing this just for instructive purposes. I wouldn't normally do this with real data. You'd never change data, of course. But to make a point here, I want to show you what would happen if we did have a non-significant result. Okay, so let's do one more just to be safe here. So let's see how this turns out. I'm going to rerun the test. So analyze, compare means, one sample t. And then everything looks good here, so let's click OK. And then here's my new result. Now notice here that the mean was 80.13 of these, you know, fictitious values here. And my p-value was 0.929. So to review, let's assess that. Is the test significant? Well, recall my decision rule. If p is less than or equal to 0.05, the test is significant. And if p is greater than 0.05, the test is not. So here we have a p-value of 0.929, definitely greater than 0.05. So the test is not significant. Okay, and look at our confidence interval. The confidence interval, does it include 0? It does, right? Because it ranges basically from -3 with rounding, all the way to 3.26, 3.27, rounding to two decimal places. So notice here how this interval includes 0, and the test is not significant, whereas this interval did not include 0, and the test was significant. So these two things will always agree, the 95% confidence interval and the outcome of the test.